Hello, my name is Akshit Saklani and today I'm gonna teach you how to rig weapons for Team Fortress 2. So we're gonna need GCFscape to extract model files from the game. We're gonna need Crowbar to decompile those model files and to compile the model that we make into a format that could be used inside the game. We're gonna need Volvum model tools. That's an add-on to 3ds Max and it is used for importing and exporting SMD files. We're gonna need 3ds Max to make our model. We're gonna need Notepad to make a QC file. The link to all these softwares will be provided in the description of the video. So we'll be starting by opening up GCFscape. We're gonna click on File, Open. And let me show you the directory here. It's Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Team Fortress 2, TF. And we're gonna open up this file. This is TF2 underscore MISC underscore DIR. So I'll be modeling a new syringe gun for Medic. So I'm gonna extract the original syringe gun. It will be in the models folder. Then weapons folder, C models. Now we're gonna search for C underscore syringe gun. Here it is. I'm gonna extract this folder on my desktop. All right. So we have all the files, all the original model files on our desktop in C underscore syringe gun folder, and this is the file that is used inside the game as model MDL file. We're gonna decompile this to get the SMD files that will be later on imported in 3ds Max. To decompile that, we're gonna use Crowbar. Under decompiler tab, browse for that file. It's on desktop, syringe gun, and then here it is. Open this up. Press decompile MDL file. So it's decompiled now. And as we can see in the C syringe gun folder, there's another folder now decompiled. And here are the SMD files that we needed. This is the one in particular that we need. C underscore syringe gun underscore reference dot SMD. We're gonna import this in 3ds Max. So let's open up 3ds Max. This is 3ds Max 2013 and we are using Volvum model tools. So I'm gonna click on Volvum importers, SMD and QC importer. Now we have various options here. I'm gonna uncheck the ones that I don't need. We need to weld vertices, so I'm gonna check this. We don't need to nullify root rotation. Make sure this is unchecked, because if this is checked, the bones won't appear in the position and that will cause a problem later on. I'm gonna uncheck remove bones because I need bones here. I'm gonna uncheck extended material search because we are not having any sort of materials right now, so we don't need this. I'm gonna uncheck create a Volvum model tool helper. So click on import QC or SMD. Now browse for the decompile file that I showed earlier. That's in C syringe gun decompile folder. Right, choose SMD here, and this is the file that I was talking about. C underscore syringe gun underscore reference dot SMD. Open this up. In this tutorial, I won't be talking about how to model things. I'll be just discussing how to rig the bones to the model. So if you want to learn how to model things in 3ds Max, you can find various tutorials on YouTube itself and everything's gonna work. So here I have the model. Let's hide the model to show the bones. Left click on the model, right click, and then hide selection. So these are the bones. Here I left clicked on this bone. This is weapon bone. Weapon bone is the bone where the player holds the gun. So this is somewhere near the trigger and the handle of the gun. Now this is another bone, VM underscore weapon underscore bone. This acts like a pivot point for the trigger. Now the third bone that we have here is VM underscore weapon underscore bone underscore one. This bone is associated with that serum jar that medics pulls in and pulls out and pushes in while reloading the gun. And the fourth bone that we have here is VM underscore weapon underscore bone underscore two. This bone is associated with the rotating syringe that we have on the gun. So let's unhide the model, right click, unhide all. So this is our model and we see that it is pointing upwards right now. So the new model that we are going to create should be in the same exact position. And as I told you, the weapon bone is somewhere near the trigger and the handle. Here it is. Here's the weapon bone, as I said. So we have to place the new model right in this position and it should be coinciding, almost coinciding with this original model. So now I'm going to talk about how bones act. Let's say the red circle is a bone and the black circle is another bone, and the black bone is the child of the red bone. We see that the triangle is pointing towards the black because it's always going to point towards the child. Now when we move the child bone, it will rotate around the parent bone. The parent acts like a pivot point. Now let's say these green circles are vertices along that are associated to the black bone. Now when we gonna move the black bone, these vertices gonna move along with the black bone. Whenever we move a parent bone, the child bone moves along with it. First of all, I have deleted everything that I imported earlier on, and now before proceeding further, I'm gonna teach you how to make new bones. So here we're gonna click on this gear like icon. It says system. So, we're gonna select bones. Now this is highlighted. This means if we left click anywhere in the on the viewport, that will be creating a bone. So left click, drag, left click, right click. Right click stops the process. Now this has created two bones. Now suppose I need to create one bone. I'm gonna left click, drag, left click again, right click. Now I'm gonna press delete. This creates one bone. So this is how we create bones. Now we need to turn this off. To do that, just click here. Now this is turned off. Now we are safe to click anywhere and we won't be creating bones anymore. Now let's select these, delete this. Now I'm gonna show you my model. This is my model and let me show you different parts of the model. Now select the model by left clicking on it. Now click on modify tab, click on element here. Now I'm gonna click on different elements here. This is the dripping mucus that will be associated to a jiggle bone so that it oscillates while moving. Now we have a flask here. Let's hide the flask. Select the flask first. Now scroll down a bit. Here we have height selected. Now below the flask we have another element. This is mucus. This too will be associated to another jiggle bone so that it jiggles while moving. Let's unhide the flask again. We have our trigger here and we have this flask that is pulled out or pushed in while reloading. Okay, so I'll be using the bones of the original model, so I'm gonna import the original model again. Volvum importers, SMD and QC. Uncheck the ones that we don't need, just like earlier. import QCSMD, choose SMD here, choose file, open. So while it is opening, let me tell you, any vertex of the model can be associated to 3 bones at max. It could be associated to 1 single bone, it could be associated to 2 bones, it could be associated to 3 bones. The amount of association with a particular bone can be edited or modified by us. So we have the original model here, and we see that our model, which is pink one, is almost coinciding with the original model. So we actually don't need the original mesh, so just left click on the mesh, delete it. Now we are left with our model and the bones. Now, as I told you earlier, this particular bone, VM underscore weapon underscore bone underscore 2, is associated with rotating syringe. We don't have rotating syringe here, so I'm gonna delete this one. And now I've got weapon bone, which is the main bone, which is the parent bone, the main parent bone. And this is the bone where the player will be holding the weapon. And we have this bone here. This is VM underscore weapon underscore bone. This is right behind this screw, as we see. This is here because this bone will be acting as a pivot point for the trigger. So it is right in the position. The third bone that we have here is VM underscore weapon underscore bone underscore 1. This will be associated to this flask. Now we need jiggle bones for this mucus in the flask and jiggle bones for the mucus there. Now, as we saw in the animation, every bone needs a parent bone to rotate around. So does the jiggle bone. So we basically need 2 bones here, one root bone and one jiggle bone. The jiggle bone will be revolving around the root bone. To make those bones, I'm gonna select this bone here. Select the bone here. Unlink selection. I'm gonna unlink this from the parent bone, because if I don't unlink it, then it will just rotate around the parent. I want to move this. So click here on select and move. Press shift, press and hold shift and move this. Alright. Select copy. Okay. Now this creates a copy of this bone. So I'm gonna position this at the right place. I need it to be at the flask. Right, let's adjust it here. This should be somewhere at the center and at the base of the mucus. So this is going to be our root bone, so I'm gonna rename it to root 1. Now our root bone is ready for this mucus in the flask. Select this bone. If you're facing problems while selecting the bones, you can just click on this drop down list and select bone here. Now it will be selecting only bones, it won't be selecting the mesh. Now again, I'm gonna create a copy of this root one. Press and hold shift, drag it, copy. Okay, now position it. It should be somewhere near the top, so that it could be associated with the top portion of the mucus. And this particular bone is going to be our jiggle bone. That means this is going to move to and fro, so that the mesh associated with it looks like appears to be oscillating. I'm gonna rename it to jiggle one. All right. Similarly, we're gonna copy these bones and create a root bone for this dripping, dripping mucus here. Shift, drag, copy, OK, position it. This should be a bit here and a bit here. Yeah, right in position. Now this is going to be the root 2 because we need a root bone here as well. The jiggle bones of this mucus will be associated to a parent so that they revolve around it, and we need a pivot point here. So this is going to be our pivot point. We're gonna rename it to root 2. Now shift drag to make the jiggle bone. This should be at the center of the dripping mucus. Copy, OK, position it. Alright, this position. Let me position it to the center. Yeah, in the center. Let's drag it a bit downwards so that this portion of the mucus oscillates. Now I'm gonna create another jiggle bone just to create a better effect. Alright, copy, OK. I'm gonna rename this to jiggle 3, and I'm gonna rename this to jiggle 2. Alright. So jiggle 3 will be using jiggle 2 as a pivot point, and jiggle 2 will be using root 2 as a pivot point. So we're gonna declare jiggle 3 as the child bone of jiggle 2. To do that, we're gonna click on select and link here. We're gonna left click on jiggle 3 to select it, and then we're gonna left click again and drag it to jiggle 2. Now as you see, the triangle here is pointing towards jiggle 3. This means jiggle 3 is child of jiggle 2. Similarly, we're gonna select jiggle 2 here. We're gonna drag it to root 2. Now jiggle 2 is the child of root 2, and everything has to be associated with, you know, weapon bone. So I zoomed in the viewport by pressing Alt plus W. Now I'm gonna select this root 2 here. Root 2 is selected. I'm gonna left click, drag it to weapon bone. Now weapon bone is parent of root 2. Root 2 is parent of jiggle 2. Jiggle 2 is parent of jiggle 3. Similarly, we're gonna do here. Root 1 has to be the parent of jiggle 1. So we're gonna click on left click on jiggle 1. We're gonna left click again and drag it to root 1. We're gonna left click on root 1 and we're gonna drag it to weapon bone. Now as we know, we unlinked this particular bone, VM underscore weapon underscore bone. So we're gonna link it back to weapon bone. Left click on VM underscore weapon underscore bone. Left click again and drag it to weapon bone. So now all the linking has been done. Now we're gonna proceed towards rigging of the weapon. Now we will be rigging the bones to the model. To do that, I'm gonna hide everything except the part that I am dealing with. So just unzoom it by pressing Alt plus W. Now here we are. Select the model by clicking on it. Go to Modify tab, Editable Poly, select Element. Now before doing anything, just go to the Editable Poly and from the drop down list, apply Skin Modifier to the model. Now here the skin is selected. in the rollout here, press add. This is the list of the bones. So basically we're going to select the bones that will be associated to the model. Control plus A to select everything. Select. Now all these bones are going to be associated to this editable poly. Alright, now click on editable poly, select element here. Click on the element that we will be working with. Scroll down a bit. Hide unselected. Alright, so we're gonna link the vertices of this mucus with root 2, jiggle 2 and jiggle 3. So the upper part of the mucus which is lying on the skull should not move, should not oscillate. So we're gonna go here, back in the skin modifier. Wait a second, just click here so that the red color goes off. Back to the skin modifier, click on root 2 here, because first we're gonna decide the vertices associated with root 2 bone. Now edit envelope. Basically 3ds max sets the vertices and associate them with bones depending upon how near a bone is to a vertice, but we will be manually tweaking everything. So click on edit envelopes, scroll down a bit. We have selected root 2 here, so come down and right, we're gonna check vertices here so that we can select the vertices that we want to associate with root 2. As we know, every vertex can be associated with at max 3 bones. All these vertex, the top part of the dripping mucus, have to be associated with root 2, fully associated with root 2, so that they do not move. Now just select all the vertices that we want to associate. Click on this wrench like icon, this weight tool, click on it. Since we want all these vertices to be fully associated with the root 2 bone, I'm gonna click on 1. 1 means they are fully associated, 0 means they are not associated at all, and these are all the values in between. So here we can see the value of association with root 2 is 1 and value of association with jiggle 2 is 0. This proportion of association is called weight. So the weight of root 2 is 1 here. Now we're gonna select the vertices that will be associated to jiggle 2. Now I'm gonna select these firstly I'm gonna select jiggle 2 here. Okay, jiggle 2. Now these are the vertices that are associated with jiggle 2 by default, and these are not fully red. That means they're not fully associated with jiggle 2. I'm gonna select these vertices here. I have selected only these vertices because I'm gonna associate these vertices partially to root 2 and partially to jiggle 2, and I'm gonna associate these vertices partially to jiggle 3 and partially to jiggle 2. So these vertices, the ones that I have selected right now, are going to be fully associated to jiggle 2. Go down, click click on this wrench. Now we're gonna click on 1. Alright, so this particular portion is completely red. That means this particular portion is completely associated with jiggle 2. Now coming back to this part, I want this part to be partially associated with root 2. So I'm gonna select root 2 back. These vertices are selected. I'm gonna click on 0.5. This means 50% association is with root 2. Now I'm gonna select jiggle 2 here. These vertices are selected. I'm gonna click on 0.5. Now these are half associated with jiggle 2 and half associated with root 2. Similarly, we're gonna select these vertices. I'm gonna select jiggle 3 here. I'm gonna move down. I'm gonna fully associate them with jiggle 3. So I'm gonna press 1 here. Alright, this part is completely associated with jiggle 3, and these vertices, they are going to be partially associated with jiggle 3 and partially with jiggle 2. So I'm gonna press 0.5 here. I'm gonna select jiggle 2 and I'm gonna press 0.5 again. So these vertices are half associated with jiggle 2 and half associated with jiggle 3. Alright, so we are done with this part. I'm gonna go back to editable poly. I'm gonna scroll down a bit and I'm gonna unhide all. Now similarly, we're gonna rig other parts of the model. Now let's hide the flask for convenience. Hide selected. Now I'm gonna select mucus and I'm gonna hide unselected so that mucus is the only visible thing here. Now the lower part of the mucus has to be linked with root 1 and the upper part of the mucus has to be linked with jiggle 1. So I'm gonna go back to skin. I'm gonna select jiggle 1 here. I'm gonna edit envelope. The vertices is already checked. Jiggle 1 is selected. Now select the vertices that I wanna link with jiggle 1. Okay, upper part of the mucus is selected. Go down to the wrench. Press 1. Alright, we are done. Now select select root 1. The lower part of the mucus has to be linked with root 1. Go down, wrench 1. This is done. Back to editable poly. Unhide everything. Now we're gonna deal with this trigger. Select trigger. This is not fully selected right now. I'm gonna select it. Right. Just done. Some of it is left. Let's zoom it by pressing Alt plus W. Now select this part also. Select this. Has to be selected. This side is selected. Now click this side. It's selected. Alright, the trigger is selected fully. Now I'm gonna hide the unselected. Hide unselected. Trigger is the only visible thing. Let's zoom out by pressing Alt plus W. Here we are. we know we have to associate the trigger with this particular bone here. Go to skin, select the bone, it's VM underscore weapon underscore one. Right now, as we can see, only the upper portion of the trigger is associated with this bone. We're gonna edit envelopes. This is already on. We're gonna go to the wrench. First, we're gonna select all the vertices. Now we're gonna press 1. Now we see the trigger is fully associated with this particular bone. Alright, go back to editable poly, unhide. Poly, select element, unhide all. Now we're gonna rig the flask. Select the flask. Right, the flask is fully selected. Hide unselected. The flask is the only visible thing right now. Now we have to associate this flask with this bone. Go to skin. Now select the bone. This bone is VM underscore weapon underscore bone underscore one. Alright, now this is highlighted. Edit envelope. This wrench. Now select all these vertices. Select all the vertices. The vertices are selected. Now press 1 so that they are fully associated with this particular bone. It's done. Alright. Go back to editable poly, and now that we have already linked the special parts of our weapon to the bones, now the remaining part of the weapon should be linked to the weapon bone, to the parent bone. So unhide all, hide the special parts, hide this flask, select it. Hide selected. Alright. Select the trigger. The trigger is selected. Right, hide the trigger. Now we're gonna select the mucus inside the flask. This one is tricky. Alright, so just I left this part. Hide this one too. Hide selected. Alright, we're gonna go inside this flask and select the mucus. Alright, we are in. Wait. Alright, the top of the mucus is selected. Let's move a bit to the side and select the side portion of the mucus as well. Alright. Now the flask is selected. Wait. Alright, I'm gonna do this by just control drag, and I'm gonna unselect the flask. So the mucus portion is selected. Alright, hide selected. Now we're gonna hide the dripping mucus. Alright. Hide this as well. So we are left with the remaining part of the weapon. Gonna go back to skin. We're gonna select weapon bone. We're gonna edit envelopes. See, right now only these vertices are associated with weapon bone, and we want all the vertices to be associated with weapon bone except the special parts that we have already hidden. So select all the vertices, scroll down, wrench, press 1. Alright, so we have rigged our weapon, it's completely done. Let's go back to editable poly, unhide all. Alright, so here we have the rigged weapon. Let's export it. Go to Volvum. Volvum exporters. Export SMD VTF file. Make sure you have clicked on you have checked reference SMD here. We don't need frames, so just change this to 0. Export non-renderable mesh as bone. Check this. Alright, export. Now I'm gonna create a new folder on the desktop. I'm gonna name it as SMD. Okay. And I'm gonna save this here as c_coldkiller.smd. Alright, I'm gonna save it here. Alright, so we have exported our SMD file. Now we're gonna export our sequence SMD. That will be our idle 1 SMD. So I'm gonna click on Volvum again. Exporters, export SMD VTF file. This time we will be checking sequence SMD. Let's turn this to 0 again. Check export non-renderable mesh as bone. Export. In the same folder, I'm going to name it idle1 and save it. It has been saved. Now we will be writing our QC file. Let's close this. Open up Notepad. I have already prepared the code, so we won't be wasting any more time. This command is used to tell the compiler that the final model, the game model, will be saved in this directory. This will be in TF folder, TF weapons, C models, C cold kill, C cold kill dot MDL. Then is body group. Body group is telling the compiler which file is our reference SMD. Then we have CD materials. This tells the compiler where have we kept our material files. Texture group skin families, that tells the compiler that we have one material for the red skin and the other material for the blue skin. This is basically used for multiple skins like in TF2. And then we have here the code for hit boxes. We can create custom hitboxes in Half-Life model viewer, and then we can generate that code and paste it here. Now we are on the jiggle bones. We're going to tell the compiler which bones are to be declared as jiggle bone. So this is the command. This one is particularly about jiggle one. So we're going to set some values here. Yaw stiffness. Yaw is the movement along z axis. The stiffer it is, the lesser it will move. Yaw damping. Damping is the resistance that the jiggle bone is facing. If you increase this value, it won't be oscillating for a long time. If you lower the value, it will oscillate for a longer time. Pitch stiffness, it is the movement along y axis. Same thing, the more stiffer it is, the less it will oscillate. Pitch damping, the same thing, resistance along y axis. More the value, it will oscillate for less time. Here we have tip mass and length, and this one is angle constraint. This is this decides to what degree will it be moving. I have placed 8 degrees here because we know jiggle one is associated with the mucus in the jar. If I'm gonna feed a bigger value here, then the mucus will appear to be moving out of the jar. So I have placed 8 degrees here so that it doesn't move too much. For jiggle 2 and jiggle 3, angle constraint value is a bit higher because that part of the mesh will be moving a lot. So this value is higher here, and even the stiffness is less here because I want this part to be moving a bit more than this part or this jiggle bone. And this is all. So we're gonna rig this, we're gonna compile this. This code will be provided in the description of the video. And let's compile. I'm gonna save it in the same folder, the SMD folder. Here I'm gonna name it as Cold Killer. Select all files here and just add .qc behind the name. Save it. Alright, it's done. Now to compile the model, I'm gonna open up Crowbar again. Now in Crowbar under Compiler tab, I'm gonna browse for our Cold Killer QC. Let's go to desktop, SMD, Cold Killer, here it is. Open it up. And here we have compile QC file. So I'm gonna compile it. It's being compiled. Alright, it is compiled. Let's check it out in the model viewer. Here is our weapon. And as we see, you see the jiggle bones? Right. So now we are in game to check our model, and as you can see, the mucus inside the flask is already jiggling as I move the weapon. And the weapon is pretty much working, as you can see. And I have created another custom model for the series. As you can see, this green mucus here. So let's add another medic to see the dripping mucus, if it is jiggling or not. I'm gonna type item test here. Check medic, add, select model. The model that we made. Alright, and we're gonna replace overdose here with our model. Okay, apply test item, and here we have another medic. And as I will be hitting him, you can see the dripping mucus, jiggling. So that's all, folks. Have fun.